Well, I was born in 1940 in a small backwater town. First of five children, but my folks were never around. Didn't take me long to find out just exactly what that bottle was. It's been called the Great Destroyer, a man, that's just what it does. When I was eight, we all moved west to turn the gold in a cowboy town. Mama played the housewife while my father fixed cars downtown. But they got itchy feet once again, and they had debts that they could not pay. So we moved to the west coast, and the coast is where we stayed. I joined the Navy in 1958 because I felt that there was nothing else to do. Trained to be a machinist, made second mate of my ship's crew. I never thought I'd see that bottle again, but I sure was wrong. A sailor hits the bottle hard when he's been away from home so long. But I got out in 1961 and I met a beautiful girl. Knocked her up so I married her, and I thought it was the end of the world. I put everything on hold just then, and then I just blamed somebody else. I let excuses get in the way of my dreams and put my dreams on the shelf. We got divorced in 1969 and I just put the blame on her. I always said that she was at fault, even though I was never really sure. But whatever the case may be, I'll be damned if I'm ever put to shame. Spend the rest of my life never taking any blame. I met and married another sometime in 1971. And in 1973 she bore me my second son. I never thought this time I'll get it right, because I knew last time was not my fault. Come the 1980s, my second marriage came to a halt. Seems my wife, she don't love me anymore, and my son just runs away. I haven't seen him for 4 or 5 years, it was 5 years last May. But he spent his whole life just making me mad and always going against the grain. He doesn't talk to me no more, and I ain't the one to blame. Whatever the case may be, I'll never take any blame.